In this tutorial, I'm going to show you three different ways to transfer your funds to the Fantom Network. These methods will cover sending from Ethereum Network, Binance Smart Chain, and even from a centralized exchange. So no matter how you want to send your crypto to the Fantom Network, I've got you covered in this video. And as a bonus, towards the end of this video, I will show you how to earn some passive income using your crypto assets. So make sure to stick with me to the end. But for now, let's get started. So I'm going to show you how to send some funds to my Fantom Opera wallet here. And there are three ways to transfer your funds to the Fantom Opera network. So the first method is the one that I use the most and recommend you do as well. And that is using Xpollinate.io to send your funds. So if we scroll down, you can see here the list of different networks that you can transfer your stable coins between. So right now, XDAI, Matic, Fantom, and Binance are available here. So obviously if you are wanting to send the Fantom token or send from an Ethereum network, then this method is not the one for you. But if you're looking for the easiest ways to send your funds to the Fantom Opera network while saving the most on fees, then this is the one for you. So we go back up to the top, you can pick the chain that you want to send from. In this case, I want it to be the Matic mainnet. So that means I'm going to have to go back to my MetaMask, click on that, and then change this to the Matic mainnet. But if you have some funds in Binance, you can select that one instead as well. But I'll choose Matic for this example. And what currency do I want to send? I'm going to choose USDC. And where do I want to send this to? I'm going to choose Fantom mainnet. So once you're happy with that and the receiving address, which should match your actual MetaMask address here, is correct, now you can click on swap. It'll pop up a MetaMask window for you to sign this contract, and you just click on sign. It'll bring up this page where you can select the amount of USDC you want to send. I only have 0.99995 of a dollar. So I'm going to click on the max. And you can see here the fees are so low. It's only 0.05 of a percent for the fees. So this is going to be by far the cheapest way that you can send funds to your Fantom Opera network. So I'm happy with that. So I just click swap. And I'm going to up the gas price a little bit here because on Matic network, it's so cheap to send transfers. This is the same as on this Fantom network, which we're about to go to. So that is a big advantage over Ethereum. The transactions fee over there can be up to $40 or $50 per transaction. Whereas on Fantom and Matic, it's going to be a fraction of a penny. So we can click on confirm and now wait for a minute or two for the transfer to go through. And that's it. Success. My transaction has gone through and I should have received 0.999 USDC on my Fantom account. So if I click on MetaMask, you can see here from the activity that I sent 0.9995 USDC on the Matic mainnet. And if I now click on here and go back to the Fantom Opera network and I click on assets, nothing shows up. That means we'll need to add our USDC token here first. So to do that, I have a quick and easy tip for you to find the contract address. So you can go to CoinGecko and type in USDC, choose the coin, and then we click on this three dot here. And then click on the MetaMask icon here under Fantom. It'll bring up a window where you can add our token. Go back to our MetaMask dashboard, and now you can see here I have 0.999 USDC. So that means my transaction through Xpollinate was successfully done. So you can see how easy that was. You're able to transact between two different blockchains with the same wallet very quickly. Now, one more tip I have using this method is that, as you know, when you're on a blockchain, the main token here is the token that's needed to pay for gas fees when you're making transactions. So there's no point having any other tokens here if you have zero Fantom tokens, because you'll not be able to make any transfers. But luckily, there's a way where you can get some free Fantom tokens, and that is to go to Fantom's official Discord channel by typing in chat.fantom.network. Once you put that in, it'll take you to their invite link. And I've already been added, so I'm just going to open my Discord now. So this is what the Fantom official Discord looks like. And to get some free Fantom, we just go here to the Fantom tip bot, click on that, and in this message box, type in the exclamation mark, and then F-A-U-C-E-T. Hit enter, and paste in your wallet address, and you should have some Fantom sent over to you. So now let's move on to the second method. This is the easiest way to actually send your Fantom token to the Fantom network, and that is through a centralized exchange called Binance. And I also have a link to this exchange and a tutorial on them as well in the description. So check them out if you don't know how to use it. Now from the withdrawal page, select Fantom as your coin that you want to transfer. And for the address, I've copied it from MetaMask by clicking on this button here and then pasting my address into this box. And for the network, now it's very important that you've picked the FTM, which is the Fantom Network. And just for comparison, you can see how much cheaper it is to transaction using Fantom. It's gonna cost less than 1 cent through the Fantom Network. And on Binance, it's 14 cents, which is still fairly cheap. And if you do this on Ethereum, it's gonna be almost $14. So there's a comparison for you and to see how useful Fantom is. Now we click on that. And the withdrawal amount, I'm just gonna do the max amount. And you can see the fee is gonna be 0.01 Fantom. If you're happy with that, click on withdrawal, click continue, enter in the verification codes, and click submit. That's it. My transaction has been submitted successfully. So now I just wait a little bit and my funds should have arrived into my MetaMask account. Just a quick note that this method should work on other centralized exchanges as well, but you just need to make sure that they do have the Fantom network here for the Fantom token. Some exchanges will only have ERC20 tokens. So if you send your Fantom coin to the ERC20 network, it'll not show up under your MetaMask account's Fantom Opera network. It'll instead show up in your Ethereum account, which is not useful for us in this case. And another note to make is that when you're transferring through centralized exchanges, your funds will not be transferred immediately. Like for example, in the first method, when everything is done through the decentralized method. So now I just refreshed my MetaMask account and it only took about 3 or 4 minutes and my 41.99 Fantom has arrived successfully to my MetaMask account under the Fantom Opera network. So that is the second method successfully done. Now for the third method, it's going to be done under the official Fantom Network's wallet. So if you type in Fantom.Foundation and then click on Fantom DeFi, then connect your wallet, click MetaMask, and then click on the wallet that you're connected to. You can see this is the same wallet that I just transferred 41.99 Fantom into. And if you want to transfer Fantom from Ethereum Network or Binance Smart Chain and don't mind paying a bit more in fees, then this method may work for you. So you would click on Receive. And then you would choose your network from here and copy this address to send your funds to, and then you can go back to your MetaMask and send it there. Do note that they have quite high fees. Last time I checked, it was around 50 Fantom to go through it using this method. So you can see here, my 42 Fantom is about $10. So it's gonna be around $12 to $13 per transaction. And that is because they need to cover the costs of the Ethereum network. So that is why I don't recommend this third method, but it's good to know anyway, and that's why I'm telling you about it. So now that we have some Fantom in our account, the next step you can do is exchange this for some other token on the Fantom network. And to do this, the main platform on Fantom right now is SpookySwap.Finance. Here's a quick question for you. What is your favorite method out of the three that I showed you for sending your funds to the Fantom network? Let me know in the comments section below. So we can go here and click on Connect Wallet, click on MetaMask again, and it'll pop up a screen where you can choose your account, click Next, and click on Connect. Now we want to go to the swap section. So this is basically a decentralized exchange where you can buy any other token on the Fantom network. So you can select the token that you want to swap Fantom for. For example, I may want to get some USDC and I may just swap to Fantom. Then you would click on swap and then click on confirm once you're happy with it. I won't do it here as I don't want to buy it yet, but that's how simple it is. And if you're finding tips like this helpful, you can thank me by hitting that like button and subscribe to my channel if you want more of these videos. Now the next thing you can do is earn some passive income through SpookySwap and the Fantom network. And to do that, we would go to farm. You can see here there are all these different pairs that if you stake them, you're able to earn an APR of 100%, 200%. There's some crazy gains here. So you can see if it's over 100%, that means within a year, your asset will double. But obviously there's gonna be some risk of impermanent loss here as you have a US dollar coin and the Fantom coin. But I won't go in depth on explaining impermanent loss here as it is more of a complicated issue. I will cover it in another video. I just wanted to get your feet wet in this video and show you the potential of earning some passive income with the cryptocurrency assets that you already own. If you're looking for more variety and want to stake your other assets like Bitcoin, Ethereum, or other altcoins as well, then it is a good idea to take advantage of these platforms, which I'm about to show you here. Plus, you can get a free sign-up bonus worth $375. So I think it's a no-brainer here. You simply just have to go to the links in the description below, sign up for these platforms and start staking your crypto to earn your standard APY and the free bonus. You can see here through my links, BlockFi will give you a $250 bonus when you stake your crypto with them. And Celsius Network is gonna be a $50 bonus. Crypto.com is also not bad at $25. Same thing with LedN at $25. And lastly, Voyager is gonna be $25 as well. My favorites, which I use for the long term, are BlockFi, Celsius Network, and Crypto.com. But LedN and Voyager are still worthwhile signing up and getting their bonus. If you want more information and more ways to earn passive income through your crypto assets, then I strongly recommend you go and watch this next video here. But if you still need more help on MetaMask, like connecting it to other wallets and dApps, or even to other blockchains, then I have a full MetaMask playlist here, which you can go and check out and choose the best video for you. And I'll see you over in the next tutorial.